2017. Sir, as Telangana Rashtra Samiti Party, we support the bill, sir. I would like to take this opportunity to draw government's attention to certain issues that states face when it comes to land acquisition and few problems that Telangana specifically has faced over the last few years. I recently came across reports that the government has started a process of making a central database of how much land it owns. It is an extremely welcome step and was very long overdue, sir. However, this tiring exercise will be useful only if these lands are put to good use. We have seen lands owned particularly by Ministry of Defence and Ministry of Railways, and they remain unused for decades together. I request the government to consider allowing state governments to construct infrastructure and special welfare projects on these lands if these lands have remained idle for decades, and the ministry anticipates so in the coming years too. Schemes of Telangana government like double bedroom housing, which we provide residents to poor people, would be a lot more feasible financially if unused central government lands were made available to us for construction. And thank you, Babuji, for also you, Mr. Babu Ravindra Babuji, thank you very much also for recommending that the land should be given for the double bedroom. And he has specially seen that it has already grounded, sir. And we have very transparently, our government has allotted double bedrooms free of cost. We have not charged a single paisa from any person for giving them the double bedroom houses. But whoever are homeless people, we have taken the government land and state government's land, and we have given that land, built the buildings about 500 square feet of house, each house. We have given them free of cost to those people. So in that type of, if these lands are really useful, it will be very good, sir. And very recently, the Ministry of Defence agreed to give its bison polo ground in Hyderabad for the new Telangana Secretariat after prolonged negotiations with the ministry. I would here like to highlight the difficulties in availing not only unused defence land, but also the land surrounding a defence establishment. According to the regulations, a permission needs to be taken from the local military authority if the proposed construction is within 10 meters from the outer wall of any defence establishment, and in certain cases the restriction is up to 100 meters. High-rise buildings are not allowed to be constructed within these limits, and restrictions of heights are laid down. The restriction limit earlier applied till 500 meters, and we appreciated the decision taken by the government to relax this limit. However, what I want to raise here is the problems that one faces when the proposed construction is just beyond these limits of 10 and 100 meters. The local military authority refuses to abide by the land records of the local revenue and administrative authority. They themselves do not conduct any land survey, and thereby it becomes a hindrance when a proposed construction activities are just outside the limits. Harassing, and not only, sir, we have put lot of application, all the people have come in the cantonment areas. Basically, this type of things are happening in Hyderabad cantonment area. And not only that, the land earlier was given on requisition to those people. Just because, as you said, the army and the war was going on, and when they came in, we gave that. But now 35,000 people are habitated in that area. All of a sudden, they come down and put the barricades and say the roads are closed. So that is not a good practice. The military, when they're giving, when the people are ready, the state is ready, each and every person is ready to really accommodate, and for the recreations or whatever are required, we are there, sir. But they cannot night and night come with their guns and with their tanks and everything and just say that this road is blocked, we will not allow you to inside. That is not the way it has to be happened. Lot of cantonment problems have been given to the defense ministry. Now also it is going on. We wanted an alternative road proposal, that also has been given. So So this type of harassment should not be done. I request the government to take a note of this issue and see to it that such practices are stopped, sir. The Prime Minister has often talked about cooperative federalism. I would like to say two things in this subject, sir, in this aspect, sir. First, whenever government has makes recuperation or acquires a land even for purpose of national security, it should take steps to take the state government into confidence. Unilateral decisions of acquiring a land without taking the state government into confidence undermines center-state relations as envisaged by our constitution. Secondly, I would like to request the government to consider a policy where in land dealings between state and center, it should be an exchange rather than monetary purchase or lease. We had a very big problem negotiating regarding the bison land, sir. So when the land, defense land, which is a government land, is given to the state land, to the state, and in that place they ask for a land, then there should not be a monetary discussion on that. The equivalent land or the double of the land, whatever is there, that should be taken. But you should not consider that day's the old rate and the today's rate registration rate and say that today's registration rate is more, so you have to give, as per that rate you have given, to have to give so much of land. That negotiation is not, should not be there in the state, between the state and center, sir. Such a policy of land exchange instead of purchase would be cooperative federalism in this, in its true essence. The minister, while moving the bill for consideration, started off by saying that any sovereign state must have the power to requisition and acquire property for defense and national security purpose. While we completely agree to this, we also believe that a state should have the power to acquire property when it meant for social welfare projects. We often see cases where an acquisition is made in good faith and with fair compensation, but still the acquisition is challenged and the social welfare projects get delayed due to litigation proceedings. So I do not want to go much into that, as we have now come up with two major projects in Telangana. One is known as Kaleshwaram project and the second one is Palamur lift irrigation project. Lot of acquisition, land acquisition has been done on that. In that, I would not like to go into this because we amicably have taken some decisions on both of people have taken on the decision. We often see cases where an acquisition is made in good faith and just as the central government incurs the loss, the state government too incurs huge losses due to prolonged litigations and compensations which has to be paid at the increased property rates. Not only does this results into financial loss, but also stalls social welfare and development projects. We request the government, which is well versed with these issues, to come up with any policy to address this matter. So the last thing which I would like to say, sir, I would also take this opportunity to particularly highlight the huge land survey undertaken by the Telangana government in September of this year under the leadership of KCR. It is a program that none of the previous governments have dared to take up, sir. We deployed more than 10,000 government employees who will undertake a comprehensive land survey over a period of 100 days and clean the ill-maintained land records. The land survey last was done during 1930s, sir, and those records continue to be in use till this date. Change of administration and officials over all these years has led to increase in irregularities and confusion. Today, more than 60% of the cases in Indian judiciary are pertaining to land titles and land records. Such a survey will take these land disputes to rest. The land records were to be carried out across 10,806 villages, and the total land to be covered was around 1.8 crores acres, sir. We have already completed 92% of the villages covering 1.5 crores acres of land. I urge the government to have a look at this program, and we have initiated and requested other state governments to adopt similar measures in order to purify the land, sir. Sir, I invite our urban development minister also to please visit Hyderabad. And this, the land survey I have seen, sir. Yeah, so the land survey which we have done after 1930, no government still now has done, sir. But we have till today 10,860 villages we have already surveyed. 92% have been surveyed, and now new title has been issued, sir. New electronic passbook is being issued. Immediately, if any land transaction has to take place, there and itself online you can do right. The transaction. You can do the payment online, get the mutation done online, so that there will be no problem for any person with the regarding the mediators. So right. Such step has been taken very boldly and very darely by the government of Telangana. So I request all the governments to request them to come and see and really put the records straight for all the states. Thank you very much.